Mathily, aka Gammer, is the English hardcore and dubstep artist. Gammer initially began his musical career as a hard dance producer before switching to hardcore and then blending dubstep and hardcore. Huge fan, by the way. He is best known for his association with UK hardcore alongside Darren Stiles, and he is also the co-founder of Together We Rise, which I believe is discontinued now. Anyway, without further ado, here are some of his tracks from 2008 to now. Gammer had his big break with his Monster Cat release to drop, which is still being played everywhere today. Such an amazing song. Anyway, since Gammer is so good at blending genres together, I can't really make one video explaining all of his sounds. So today, we're gonna focus on This Is The End, featuring David Spector as well. Such amazing vocals. So just sit back, pop a soda, and let's send some hardcore. Okay, I'm sorry. I just had to do this. Hold on, one second. Let me rewind. All right, guys, straight into the drums. So what you want to do first is grab a really good kick. This kick is from my sample pack, if you want it. Link in the description. 100% free. So first, you want to pick a kick that's really prominent in 200 hertz area, has lots of a low end. Let me play it once. It has a really round character, this kick, but however, this kick is missing some top end, so this is where you're gonna go through your sample library and find a nice top layer. This is what I came up with. And then you want to have a stereo layer which will ensure your kick is still heard in stereo. What does it mean? It does not mean your kick should be in stereo. It just should mean that the attack of the kick should have some kind of bright stereo. So because when elites are playing, the attack of the kick might get drowned or not be as prominent. In the end, it comes back to taste, but I felt like this is what not many UK hardcore producers do nowadays. So that's how it sounds. It's from the Kashmir Volume 3 pack. Other percussion, you have a right hit every fourth beat, I guess. And you have, let me see, so here, some tambourine loops, shaker loops. Just adding some groove, you know, so it doesn't sound static or aesthetic. Processing. So it's really important with kicks. You're supposed to really fine tune the kick. What does it mean? Let me explain. So if I turn off this EQ right now, you're gonna hear it sounds horrible. All right, Jesus Christ, what the fuck was that? All right, sorry. Let me just do it like this. All right, anyway, this is how it sounds without EQ. It's very muddy. I don't know if you hear it, but this sounds very muddy to me. That's why I went into the EQ and cleaned up those frequencies that could potentially clash with any of the other elements. Also, one trick in UK hardcore is you have a high pass around 40 to 50 hertz, depending on how prominent you want your sub to be. This way, you really make sure your sub has so much air to breathe that you can just crank that volume up to get modern sound, I guess. So for here, I went with like a bit higher of a slope, and then I just added a saturator for some fullness, I guess. So this hot sounds without this saturator. Of course, I could just crank the volume up, but I want it to clip for the harmonics.
All right, guys, listen up. I know you guys think there's a secret ingredient to make big fat leads, but what if I told you it's actually as simple as putting a hamburger together? All right, just imagine a hamburger patty on its own. It tastes okay, but it's not a hamburger. It's not juicy. It doesn't have that much flavor, not that much character, right? So just imagine hamburger, but the hamburger's elite. So we have to put multiple things into that hamburger to make it a hamburger. However, if you put too much garbage in it, or just too much of anything, it won't even resemble a hamburger anymore. So let me show you what I mean.
Okay, so I'm gonna play everything together first. Okay, so I'd like to dissect every layer one by one now, starting with the patty, of course. So to get the end kind of sound, the pitch bend is very important. Let me explain. Without the pitch bend, it sounds like this. It does not have the end kind of vibe. So to get this effect, all you have to do is get an envelope. I use the LFO because I feel I get more control over the curve. So this is the curve. It's on envelope. It's on 6.3 hertz, negative minus 24, I believe. Yeah, 24, minus 24. Both oscillators. So next layer is spire. It's basically a very detuned lead, very stereo, as you can see. Everything is white. The reason why it's heavily detuned is because the main layer does not really have that much detune. It's more clean, more mids, I guess. But this one more like the highs. So to fill out the stereo spectrum, so to say, I added this one. The tomato. Just very gritty. Helps everything blend in more together. The pickle. If you don't like pickles, blow me. Adds lots of crunch, lots of high end, has a bit more release than the other leads. However, not in a way where it would interfere with the main sound. Let me play it together. Now, without it. See, it just only supplements and supports the main layer. It's not like its own entity where it's fighting for the same frequencies. It's more like its own little buddy there. Minding his own business, but at the same time helping him. So the most important thing now is, how do we glue this together so it sounds like one big lead, right? The answer is the chord stack. So let's move to the effects. So with the reverb, it sounds like this. Very simple stuff. About 8 seconds delay, decay. To get the really modern, clean reverb sound, all you have to do pretty much is just this high ratio here. Has to go all the way down, not all the way, but very low. Let me demonstrate this. This reverb does not sound good. It has too many highs, so that's why we took this down. That's a good reverb. What else? I sidechained the reverb to delete. The way you do this in FL Studio is you go to the settings here, the cogwheel. And then processing, then stereo sidechain in, and you pick the insert. And then you pick external source, and bam, it's done. Other things that are important is this background path here. So let me play it on its own. Pretty much it does just fill out the whole spectrum. So it sounds big, and because the melody doesn't really like hold, it doesn't sustain one note. So you need this kind of background elements to fill out those gaps. All right, guys, if you have followed me all along till now, you should be able to remake this one-to-one, kind of. Guys, if you like this video and you want to see more, please like and subscribe. That way I know you guys want more. Please comment if you have questions or any kind of feedback. This is my first video I'm doing like this, so go easy on me. Don't blast my ass too much. And anyway, enjoy your day, guys, and I'll see you next time.